Hi, welcome in Modern Pathshala. I am Ashish. In this video, we are going to learn bundling and minification in MVC. This is a practical hands-on course. Bundling and minification is one of the important concepts introduced by Microsoft in ASP.NET MVC. Bundling combines multiple files together in a single downloadable unit. Minification is a process to minimize the file size so that how fast a file can be downloaded over a single HTTP request. In this video, we will learn need of bundling and minification, followed by a demo application, how to implement bundling and minification in ASP.NET MVC. So let's get started. Why we need bundling and minification? The simple answer to this question is we want to improve the page load time. So what are the factors on which page load time depends? We will look into this video. So as we may know, most of the browser limits number of simultaneous connections to get an asset per host name. Mostly browsers allow 6 simultaneous connections to get an asset per host name. We can see the real values on the browser escape. Here on the browser escape on network tab, we can see Google Chrome allows 6 simultaneous connections. Firefox allows 6 simultaneous connections, i11 and i10 allows 6 and 8 simultaneous connections respectively, i11 allows 13 simultaneous connections respectively. So most of the browser allows 6 simultaneous requests per host name. So suppose we have a web page that requires 10 CSS files, 15 JS files and additionally some images to load. So for a complete page load, browser have to make 25 plus HTTP request. So let's see how this will behave in a demo application. So here I have created a simple ASP.NET MVC 5 demo application using Visual Studio 2015. Here in the home controller, I am returning my home page from index view. My index.cshtml file is using the layout.cshtml file. We can set the layout.cshtml file here, or we can also set from the viewstart.cshtml file. So let's see how layout.cshtml file is using the resource. So layout.cshtml file having jQuery library, jQuery intelligence.js, jQuery UI.js, jQuery validate.js, unobtrusive.js, modernizer, responder, bootstrap. So in this demo application we have these number of files. So in real application this list may grow, as real application have different capabilities, different functionalities. To implement those functionalities we require additional JS and additional CSS files. Overall idea is this: we have multiple number of files to load with a page. So let's make a quick build and run the application. So here on the Google Chrome, let's open developer tool. On the network tab, let's disable the cache. Yes, okay. So let's refresh the page. So we can see the browser have to make 9 requests for JS files and 22 requests for the CSS files. So on the timing tab we can see initially browser makes 6 simultaneous requests, after that additional requests are queued by the browser. If we click any of them, we can see the here waiting time is 22 milliseconds. So after that all requests will be processed when the initial request will be finished. We can see that total load time page is 1.83 seconds and browser have to make 410 KB data transfer for the page load. We can also check same on the different network conditions. Let's test on the regular 3G connection, 750 KB limit. So let's refresh the page. So now we can see the total download time is completed in 6.14 seconds, and here is the waiting time. We can see again 183 milliseconds. So overall idea is this. We have different number of files for need to download for this complete page load. So how we can reduce these number of files and the size of the files? How ASP.NET MVC will help us here? So let's see in the followed video. Thank you.